Hey guys, Dr. David Jockers here, and today we're talking about six ways to reduce inflammation in your body. And so we know inflammation is basically an immune response where your immune system's literally trying to save your life, because we know that infections have killed more people in the history of mankind than anything else. And inflammation is something that our body does to prevent against a bacterial infection from getting in and spreading throughout our body. And so inflammation, trying to save your life, however, it's causing a lot of problems. When we think about things like arthritis or colitis, anything with that itis ending, that's inflammation. When you have eczema or acne or rosacea, that's inflammation of your skin. When you have irritable bowel syndrome or leaky guts, inflammation of your gut. When you have thyroiditis, inflammation of your thyroid. So you can see inflammation affects all different tissues of our body. And we really need strategies to be doing on a daily basis to keep inflammation under control. You know, in our society, we don't think about people dying in first world countries of infections. That's what used to happen to people. But instead, our body's gotten good at this inflammatory process. We no longer die from infections, but we die from chronic inflammation affecting all different regions of our body. And so even heart disease is related to chronic inflammation in the arterial lining. So six ways, things that we can do on a daily basis to reduce inflammation in our body. Number one is hydration. You've gotta drink. Hydration is so key for getting toxic compounds out of our body. Overgrowth of different bacteria and microbes in our system, helping just flush our gut, helping just, in a sense, pee and poop and sweat out your toxins, right? You gotta get the hydration in there. The better hydrated you are, the less inflammation you're gonna have in your body. So really focus on good water, get some good salts in your water, whether it's Himalayan sea salt or you're doing an organic broth, get those electrolytes in there and just keep cranking the water. So I'm a big fan of drinking your full body weight in ounces. And I know the kind of gold standard is drink half your body weight in ounces. So if I weigh 160 pounds, half my body weight would be 80 ounces of water. But you know what, if I wanna really flush my system, as long as I'm getting the electrolytes, doing good salts, then what I wanna do is actually drink a full 160 ounces of water on a daily basis. That's just gonna flush toxins out. It also helps you get rid of hunger and cravings and helps your brain just come on fire. You end up with more energy, better mental function, memory, cognitive acceleration, all the great benefits that come with just feeling clean and healthy. So hydrate well, that's number one. Number two is you gotta move your body. So if we are stagnant, if we are sedentary, that's gonna cause poor circulation, it's gonna cause a lot of metabolic waste to sit in our joints and cause more inflammation and pain and discomfort in our body and a whole host of different health problems. So you gotta move, you gotta get up, you gotta take walks, get outside, you know, go out and do stuff, right? Just move your body, stretch. Do different things that are gonna help improve your circulation. You could do cold showers, for example, where you cycle between hot and cold water. There's a number of different things you can be doing to improve movement and circulation in your body, so critical for reducing inflammation. Also, number three is gonna be diet, right? If you're eating foods that promote inflammation, that's gonna be things like sugar and carbohydrates that turn into sugar. So even if it's like, you know, eating a bowl of rice, that's gonna turn into sugar in your body and promote inflammation. So stay away from sugar, stay away from high carbohydrate foods. Also, you wanna stay away from vegetable oils and trans fats, hydrogenated oils and things like corn oil, cottonseed, canola oil, peanut oil, sunflower oil, these sorts of plant-based vegetable oils. Stay away from those. Instead, switch to coconut oil, olive oil. You want things like grass-fed butter, which is really good, avocados. Get those really good fats in, make those a priority point in your diet. Consume a ton of non-starchy, low-carbohydrate vegetables, okay? That's super important, a lot of herbs and spices, very important. Low-glycemic fruit like berries, lemons, and limes, an amazing way to reduce inflammation. And then change the meat that you eat. Get rid of commercial-raised animal products and bring in grass-fed, pasture-raised, sustainably raised animal products, which provide so much more nutrients and significantly less toxic metabolites than the conventional. Conventional meat products promote inflammation. Grass-fed, sustainably raised animal products are anti-inflammatory. They reduce inflammation in your body. So definitely be sure to plug those in. We got to reduce stress. So if you're somebody that's out there and you feel like you're stressed out all the time, maybe it's your job or your relationship, you've got to figure out coping strategies to reduce stress in your life. You know, there's a lot of research about how when we are stressed, inflammatory markers, these inflammatory cytokines, they go way, way, way up. And sometimes they can stay up for days at a time, right? And so just promoting inflammation, weakening our immune response, making us more susceptible to catching a cold, fever, or flu, and promoting pain and discomfort in our body. So we gotta get stress under control. And one way you can do that is really sleeping good, right? Focusing on very good sleep habits. You know, we're all gonna have stress every single day. There's no getting around it. But if we are recovering well from the stresses of our day, then we're gonna be able to handle those stresses and become more resilient and adaptive to those stresses. And so how do you rest well? I'd recommend, you know, definitely getting in bed before 10 p.m., right? I know for some of you guys out there, you're like, 10 p.m., come on, right? But you gotta do it. Why? Because every hour before midnight is equivalent to 3 hours of regenerative and stress balancing potential after midnight. Meaning that if I were to get 8 hours of sleep, but I slept from 10 to 6, it would actually be 6 hours more significant of rest and recovery than if I slept from 12 to 8. So the more that we can get to bed early, around 10 p.m. is an ideal time, the better off we're gonna be. And we have a lot of videos and articles on our website that go over proper sleep hygiene, right? Different strategies you can take to help you sleep, fall asleep quicker and get deeper and more restorative sleep on a regular basis. But we gotta rest well. Again, that's gonna give us that greater adaptive and resilient capabilities so we can handle the stresses that we encounter each and every day. So all of those strategies. And last but not least, you know, add in some powerful supplementation. Omega-3 fatty acids are a really powerful way to reduce inflammation. High dose omega-3s, getting 2 to maybe up to 5 or 6 grams of EPA and DHA purified fish oil supplement can be extremely helpful. Curcumin, which is the active ingredient in turmeric, that orange Indian spice, right? Putting turmeric in your food is great, but even better getting standardized curcuminoids in a supplement form, ideally more of like a liposomal form that crosses through the gut into the cells, works really, really good with curcumin. And also vitamin D can be helpful. Also glutathione boosting agents are great for reducing inflammation. Things like N-acetylcysteine or liposomal glutathione or acetylated glutathione. Glutathione is your body's master antioxidant. It regulates the immune system. If you have chronic inflammation, it's a sign you're glutathione deficient. So addressing that with lifestyle strategies and good supplementation is powerful. The supplement, my number one anti-inflammatory supplement, is this Pro Omega CRP, which combines the power of liposomal curcumin, so curcuminoids, as well as high dose EPA DHA, that fish oil, purified molecularly distilled fish oil, no toxins in it, and it's got liposomal glutathione, high absorbency capacity, gets right into your cells, helps support those. I put people on this supplement to help balance out blood sugar and reduce inflammation in their body, and we see tremendous results quickly. So if you follow those strategies, I know you're gonna see significant changes with your health, your energy, your inflammation, pain levels, all your major organ systems, they're all gonna start improving. And you're gonna be moving towards your health potential. So go ahead and leave a comment in the comment section below and let us know what you're doing on a regular basis to keep inflammation under control. And we will see you in a future video. God bless you.